thank my friend Alf on the way over. It's hard to impress a guy that's a world-class skater and shoe designer. Maybe this will do it. I'll load up my old oatmeal box with some smoke. Let's see how I did. Sweet. I smell a skater.
What up, Jake?
Look at here. Check this out. A little bit of sweet.
Oh, sweetness. Wow. That's awesome. Right on, my man. You're always up to something.
So can we make some nylon?
We should make some nylon.
Let's make some nylon. We're going to make some nylon. It just so happens I have
look
some
at that.
Nylon materials right here. Who would have thought?
I'm wondering how this stuff goes from this to nylon. I thought nylon came from nylon trees, no?
Nylon trees are, well, nylons are little animals.
Were you pulling my leg when you said that?
Actually, nylon is made from chemicals.
If I poured these two chemicals together, would I get a Nike Cortez?
What's a Cortez?
Let me show you.
The Cortez. That sounds kind of painful. Oh, shoe.
This is one of Nike's classic shoes that I used to wear when I was a kid. I really love it for the nylon that it has here. It's got a cool sheen to it. It's lightweight and breathable. But the biggest problem is that it's not resistant to abrasion. And at the basis of every skateboard trick is the ollie. Do you know what an ollie is?
Is that where you jump down on it and kind of flip it up in the air?
It's basically jumping up in the air with your skateboard.
Without
using your hands.
Oh, yeah.
Because we're lazy like that. We don't reach down and grab. Why do all that, right?
Anti-gravity feet.
So after one full day of skateboarding, nylon is done.
Oh, it's ollie abuse. You want it to grip but not tear.
An ollie-proof Cortez.
One thing that's interesting, if you look closely, you see it's woven. Made out of nylon threads. So we're going to make a nylon thread. We might have to change your expectations a little bit once you find out what nylon is. It's actually a simple chemical reaction.
Okay.
It's called polymerization. And that's where you take molecules and hook them together in long chains. So I'm going to take these two chemicals and put them in a beaker. And the reason I have them in little bottles is this is kind of mean stuff. It uses something close to gasoline. It's hexamethylenediamine or hexadiene solution. Pour that in there. Okay.
Here's the nylon.
And I'm gonna take the sebacyl chloride. This is kind of like a salt.
Sebacyl.
S-E-B-A-C-Y-L. Sebacyl. Have you ever seen a drink or something, or like salad dressing, where one liquid floats on top of the other?
Yes.
This is very critical to making this. I'm gonna try to get this liquid to float on top of that one. So I'm just gonna pour this in real carefully. Ooh, you see something?
Oh, wow, yeah,
It started to react.
Nothing even poured in there and it started reacting.
Yeah,
that's incredible.
Some mean stuff. So I'm just gonna pour this down the side and try to get it to float on top. Right now, at the interface where the two liquids are meeting, there's a chemical reaction taking place, a polymerization reaction. And it is floating on top, isn't it?
Oh, wow, yeah, that's amazing.
So now we've got a little layer. I wanna have you reach down and just try to pinch that. That way, if there's an accident, I will not be harmed. Let's see if you can grab that stuff. There you go.
Pull
it out.
Ooh. Whoa, check that out. Ooh. What a trip.
Here, I'll grab that. It keeps on coming and it keeps on coming. This is like the booger that won't quit.
Right.
Pull that out of your nose. I wonder how long we can make this thing. I'll tell you what, let's set this up so we can see a nice long thread, shall we?
Yeah.
Here we go. You have nylon down there, Al?
I sure do.
Okay, weave some shoes.
Now that we understand how nylon's made, how do we make it abrasion resistant?
Well, I don't know if you and I can do that ourselves. Organic chemistry research has been going on for about 100 years. And just the invention of nylon was a decade or so. And we've been working on this about 20 minutes. I don't think we're going to come up with exactly the answer. But I think we can head our thinking in a better direction to get to the answer.
Okay.
And scientists have to be happy with that. We'll have to find a different material. And it might already be out there. They probably just don't want it out because the shoes will never wear out.
That's a good point.
We could probably make this completely bulletproof.
Okay.
Probably be so heavy you couldn't walk, you know?
I think sneakerheads would still want it.
What scientists do when they come up, they do some more research. I bet there are materials that would withstand grinding. Even though I don't have an exact answer for you, I think that answer could be achieved.
That was awesome, Jake.
That was chemistry, brother.
I really learned a lot today. It was pretty amusing to see how nylon was made. I've never seen that process before.
So I actually taught you something?
You really did.
Well, guess what?
What's that?
I'm putting it on you. You got to teach me how to do one of those ollie things.
Oh, I can teach you how to do one of those ollie things.
You think you can?
Yeah, let's do it.
80-year-old man out there on the wheels.
We're going to teach you how to ollie. Sneaker
science. Let's go.